Hi everyone, just making this quick video to share the custom UI mesh renderer I made. So it turns out you can actually override the UI to use custom meshes, which opens up a lot of fun options. You will find a link to all the files you need in the description. Here are some of the meshes I made for this showcase. The UVs are all laid out vertically and squished into one UV square, which means that scrolling textures work very nicely on it. Here's what I made. It's a UI mesh renderer script that takes a material, a mesh, gives the option to use it as a mask while showing the mask graphic or not. It can be masked itself, and there's an option to preserve the aspect when you change the width and height. So let's have a look at the script. There are two very important functions here. The first one is canvasRenderer.setMesh, which will set your custom mesh. And then there is setMaterial, which will set the UI material that you want. Now, if you just set the mesh like this, there are some scaling issues because the mesh doesn't know about the RecTransform you are using in the UI. So it would be completely relying on the scale of the UI element and the mesh size. So instead of directly setting the mesh into the UI, I've created a new function that will create a new mesh that is scaled based on the rect transform. It takes the bounds of the mesh and then scales them based on the rect transform width and height. And then here we have aspect ratio preservation that I just took from the image component. And then finally we take these scales and use it to scale up all of the vertices in the mesh, and then we return that scaled up mesh. And then finally here we have how to set up the masking using the stencil buffer. So this is how you turn it into a mask, and then using the color mask you can make sure that it shows the graphic or that it ignores the graphic. And then if you want the mesh to be masked by another mesh, you can set these values, and then it'll only show up inside of the other mesh. So about the UI materials, you can use shader graph, but then you would lose the ability to do any kind of masking because you need to add the stencil buffer for the masking to work. And at the time of making this video, shader graph does not support adding your own stencil buffer. So I've used just normal code shaders here. I've provided two examples of UI shaders in the description. There is a progress bar shader, this one, and one that just has a scrolling texture with a color map. These shaders are very simple, so they work in both URP and built-in, and you can download a few of these example meshes I made in the linked post too. Okay, very quick setup. To use this, just drop the UI mesh renderer script onto an empty game object in your UI. Drag in a mesh. Make sure that the mesh has read-write enabled. And drag in a UI material, and that's it. The mesh will scale with the RecTransform settings. And if you hit preserve aspect, it won't stretch at all. To use it as a mask, just hit the mask toggle, and then if you hit the mask graphic, you'll see the mask again. Let's duplicate this as a child, and then we set this one to be maskable. Let's change the graphic. And it's masked. You can also use 3D meshes, but be aware that the set sorting might get a bit confused. One last thing, if you make any updates to your mesh, make sure to disable and enable the scripts so it'll update the mesh. You won't automatically see the changes here. That's it for today. Check out my GitHub site for more tutorials and resources, and a big thank you to all my patrons who make these tutorials possible. Thanks for watching, have fun, and see you in the next one.